Welcome to the show, Sanjay. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, thank you.
And your teaser is also doing very well. You have written, produced and directed Mumbai Saga. It's about when Bombay was not Mumbai and when violence ruled the streets.
Yes.
What inspired you? Went to a mall one day and thought about the time it was a mill?
No, not at all. As a matter of fact, on my last couple of films, you know, there's a lot of research we've done on films like Lokhandwala and Wadala. And at that time, one of the stories that did pop up was this story, which later became Mumbai Saga. And it was also about, you know, the change, how the landscape of Bombay changed, and which primarily was the shutting down of the mills. And, you know, in place of them came all your malls and the high-rise buildings and this and that. But how did that start? You know, how did that happen? What was the story behind it? Why did they do it? That is a very interesting story that, came. And that and a couple of other stories. So what we've done is we've kind of combined elements from history, from the history of Bombay. And it's very much inspired by true events, although the characters are fictitious. We've created our own characters, but the events in the film are actually what happened on the streets of Bombay.
And violence is a subject that seems to intrigue you a lot. You do it very stylishly as well. But, I think we're going to be seeing a lot of your trademark shots in this film. Am I right?
Yeah, I guess so.
And also, see, your favorite is there in the film. We have John Abraham. But where's Sanjay Dutt?
Well, Sanjay Dutt will be in the next, surely. You see, the thing is that, you know, with Sanju and myself, we've had a history of some incredible films, and there is a legacy that we have. And if I have to go back to Sanju, I have to go back to him with a script that, you know, lives up to that legacy. And hopefully that should happen soon.
And what is it about John that excites you so much as a protagonist?
For the kind of movies I make, John is a perfect fit. I mean, I believe in good-looking heroes and, well-built and stuff like that, because it's very important for me to, you know, when I present heroes as heroes and put them in the right clothes, everything down to the details, even to the chappals or sandals he's wearing or the watch on his hand or the, you know, bracelet and the locket on his neck, everything. So, I mean, John is somebody, firstly, he's got the personality, he's got the persona, the charisma. And even as an actor, over the years, he has just kind of literally transformed himself. And we have a level of understanding. This is our third film together. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of comfort.
All right. And it's a multi-starter. You know, all your films are multi-starters. This one has John Abraham, Imran Hashmi, Sunil Shetty, Kajal Agarwal, Rohit Roy, Anjana Sukhani, Mahesh Manjrekar, Pratik Babbar. I can't even name the rest. There's so many of them.
And now, Amol Gupte.
And Amol Gupte. Of course, Sameer Soni. I can't, you know, there's so many.
Yeah.
Like I said, but tell me, film stars, are their egos easy to manage on sets?
Absolutely. I see. The thing is that mainly most of the names you've taken are I have worked with in the past, except for Imran and Amol and Pratik. And the thing is that I work with people that I'm comfortable with. When I asked Anna, that is Sunil Shetty, to do the film, he didn't even ask me what the script is. And although it's a cameo, it's a special appearance, you know, but he has that faith in me. And even at my end, I cannot let that faith down. Mm-hmm. So, although it's going to be a short role, you know, but I guess we trust in each other. And that's my equation with most of my other actors. So, and for me, the script is always sacrosanct. So once the script is locked, that is shared with the actors and everything, I do listen to their suggestions. If I want to use them, I'll also use them and things like that. But mostly, after that, we just stick to the written script. That's it.
And you're one of the first films to go on floors when Maharashtra government gave the green signal for shoots. But you, of course, went and did that in Ramoji City in June 2020, you know, when COVID scare was right at its peak.
Right. No, we didn't. We were planning to. We were supposed to do that. Mm-hmm. But we didn't have very much. We didn't have a lot of work. So we decided to do it here when things settled a little more.
All right. So you had some patchwork to do. Did you do that?
Yeah, of course.
Did you
yeah,
do
we
that?
did. No, we did it post the lockdown, but also we did it at a time when things had not really resumed. There was still a lot of fear and a lot of anxiety, you know, in shooting. And because see, the COVID is something that none of us saw coming, and we don't really fully understand it even today. You know, so that's the whole thing. But anyway, we managed, we shot, and we finished the film.
You know, this is a film about gangsters, even though they are fictitious. You'll see the kind of controversies all the films are running into today. As a filmmaker, does that concern you?
Well, of course it concerns me. Everything that's happening around us is very alarming. The absolute and complete, what shall I say? It's not really a breakdown, but tolerance. You know, I mean, at the end of the day, we're just, it's entertainment. It is not to be taken that seriously. We are not rewriting history. We are not, if we're showing something in a film or showing something in a show, there's a reason we're showing it and we're not doing it. I mean, no, I don't think anybody in the film industry or the television industry or the OTT platform, you know, is doing it to malign anybody on purpose. So I just feel that politics and religion should be kept away from entertainment.
Okay, and what do you feel about, you know, the people's sentiments? You know, you show a gangster who is of a certain religion, for instance.
Right.
You know, does that is that something you considered, you know, post-shooting?
No, not at all, yeah. You know, what is the religion of the gangster? And I don't consider that at all. My point is that I'm making films on real gangsters. For example, Lokhandwala was about a gangster called Maya Dolas. Who was a Maharashtrian boy. Vadala was about a gangster called Manya Surve. Okay, who was again, so I'm not thinking in my head that no, then it also had characters, other gangsters that were from, that were Muslims. So I'm not looking at that shit. I never had that, you know, this is, he's a Hindu gangster or a Muslim gangster or any of that. I mean, that's something, even as an industry, we have always kept away from, we've never gotten into that whole space.
Well, yes, absolutely. I think there's been equal opportunity in all your films for everyone to be gangsters, but absolutely everyone is a gangster. That is something for sure. And I'm really looking forward to this, Sanjay. And before I let you go, could you tell us like what we can expect from the trailer?
You can expect a lot of fireworks. You can definitely expect Kajal Agarwal, who is not there in the teaser, sadly. But yeah, but I can guarantee that you can expect a very powerful trailer. We've really worked hard at putting it together, and it's got all the elements that we have missed in the movies for over a year now.
Exactly. This is going to be releasing on the big screen. Did you ever think to take the OTT route? Do you ever consider that?
No, not at all. In the same, I mean, there was a time when there was so much uncertainty. We didn't know whether we'll come into the theaters or not, and this and that. So yes, my producer, Mr. Bhushan Kumar, did weigh all the pros and cons and the options and everything. So yeah, I mean that's how it was. But we are happy that we're finally coming into theaters. We're the first film coming, and I do hope and pray that people come to the theaters.
Well, I hope so too, and I think they will, to watch the fireworks on the big screen. Thank you so much, Sanjay. That was a great chat. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Today. Yeah.